Hi everyone, I'm Cassie Kozyrkov, and I'm recording this the day that OpenAI released Operator. What's Operator? It's their brand spanking new agentic system. Have I tried it? No, not yet. This is what this video is going to be about. Welcome to Operator. So it's a system that's going to be performing tasks for us using a web browser. We'll see how it goes. I have not actually clicked on that next button. Now, in order to get to this step, you need to have the super fancy $200 a month version of ChatGPT. In we go, next. Okay, it can make mistakes. Of course it's gonna make mistakes. Now, it's a remote browser. It retains screenshots of its actions. Okay, don't do anything that you wouldn't wanna be associated with. Agree and continue. Okay, what can we do? A meal with chicken, no thank you. Let's see. So here are some suggestions, and they all seem to be about food and tickets. What categories do we have? Delivery, local services, shopping, travel, news. Help. Oh, interesting. Help me book a... Okay, so I typed a whole bunch of stuff, which I'm gonna zoom through so you don't suffer. I want a hotel in New York. My ideal taste is like me, weird and wonderful. I hope I'm at least one of those things. Which one? Boutique, moody maximalist decor, unusual, and I'll just throw that word romantic in there because it couldn't hurt. It should be in Manhattan, clean, and within walking distance of several cafes that make a perfect flat white. So, already a little bit of tendrils of searching should be expected. You would need to check outside of the pure booking websites, so I don't know if this is going to be a stretch for dear little operator or not. We'll find out. And I also said look for good deals where the hotel is either less expensive than similar quality hotels or on discount from its usual. And let's find out what we get. Let's allow notifications, which my browser immediately blocked. Good, perfect. Unique romantic hotel. Unique romantic hotel. The one AI tells the other AI. And both the one AI takes together AI. Let's see it. And both make mistakes together. Let's see it. Okay, so we're going to booking.com and Manhattan. So far, so good. Which dates? Do we get the right dates? The 5th. This. The 4th. That's good. That's good, little one. Until the 14th. Try again, my darling. Those were not my dates. I mean, maybe the 14th is a kind of date, hopefully, if you're lucky. Okay, so we have our first little failure is happening here that it got the right first date, but the incorrect last date. So it's not like I would want this thing actually running off and doing tasks on my behalf so far, but interesting. Look. This is completely impressive. I mean, imagine this 10 years ago. It would have blown your mind. It would have blown my mind. I've been in AI for a long, long time. I spent 10 years at Google, where I started in research and machine intelligence and eventually became Google's chief decision scientist. So I've been playing in the AI space a while. And let me tell you, we are a bunch of piglets for taking today's generative AI capabilities for granted and being like, oh no, look, it got the one date right, it got the other date wrong. I mean, I'm as guilty as anyone, but yeah, we are a bunch of piglets not appreciating just how marvelous this is. All of it, technology, humans. Wow. And so at the end, the Moxie Lower East Side is what it chose. Not that bad of an option, but it still isn't going to give you the results you get if you were a local looking. Right. The dates should be 4 to 12. Mm-mm. Now it found me March. How interesting. Oh, no, better. February 4th. Let's go. February 12th. Let's do it. Let's... No! Oh, it's like that meme with the round hole and the square hole and the... Yeah, no. I have so much hope. All right, I give up. Let's see if I can go back. Let's imagine that I wanted to book the Moxie. See? So there I am, it found me the Moxie. Now, what if I wanted to actually reserve this? Exit to chat. So what can we see here? All the things it's doing. Searching, accessing booking.com. Let's see, where was it? And I like this replay. I can see what actually happened. Closing unnecessary sign-in pop-up, nice. Selecting the February 12th. Right. So something that we don't see here is the smart use of multiple tools, the kind of search that you would actually need to do in order to figure these things out. Well, it would involve something about coffee shops. It would involve something about the map. And this is all happening within one tool at a time. So the idea of in parallel, go figure out where the cafes are, go figure out what the hotel options are, compare, see if you've got some radius match, find the hotel on the map, see what's around it, that kind of thing. That's not here. So far it looks like one tool at a time. Okay. Create. I'm not going to read, I'm going to type, I'm going to zoom for you, and then I'm going to read. Ah, misfire. But it does look like we can have two tasks in parallel. So, stop that. Play name. All right, now this thing would take me a really long time to make if I were to make it myself. All the plays in February 2025, their names, their opening date, closing date, website, theater name, company name, director, and actor names, which is called cast. If I were a real theater person, I would know that. Yeah. Oh, and also playwright. How dare I? Stop. Again. Playwright. Okay, there. Now, as I was saying, this would take me an enormous amount of time to make myself. Somewhere all along, I've had this little inner theater nerd that has been with me since I was a kid, and that made me go to acting school for a month last month, which was incredibly fun, very fulfilling. It kicked my butt. It was It was good to be solidly at the bottom of the class because that program is a tough program and it's for mid-career actors, and I, mere keynote speaker, was a little bit fish out of water there, but I survived and I learned so many things, so very proud of myself. Anyway, point is, a nerd like that would have a spreadsheet kind of like this. And then you're like, show, or it didn't happen. Okay, let me show you. Gathered information on 3 plays. Okay. I'm sure that, so what I can tell you is that this information is available. You just have to dig for it. All right, so let's try booking a flight. Book a flight for 1 economy class. Let's see how we solve this. With kayak, as do we all. To try to give you something watchable, that's going to be a video within the watchability of your attention span, is going to mean that I am going to wildly misrepresent the effectiveness of this tool. Operator is so slow. I have been sitting here trying to find things to ramble. I don't know if they'll make it into the video, but as I watch this, this is like, I mean, if you were watching an intern go this slowly, you would want to force feed them espresso. It wouldn't be allowed. It would be very much, very much not good labor practices, but it would cross your mind. Aha, the idea that this is a one-way flight does not cross this thing's bits. There we go. Way direct. Book directly with the airline. Aha. But will it know what it's booking? All right, I'm quite impressed with this, really. And let's see. This is not a situation I'm in, IRS or whoever, just imagining. I have dissolved a Delaware corporation. I did it on time. I'll have you know. Okay, so now it's asking me, can you confirm if the corporation ever commenced operations? No stock was awarded. Yes, please download. Okay, where does it go if it downloads? Yeah, what are we gonna do with this now? Thank you, I think. Free online tool to create an infographic about AI agents from scratch. Like, you need to do things in parallel because each one is just so slow. But again, it's just going to get faster and better. Okay, so to use Canva's infographic maker, you need to log in or sign up. And now we find another amazing use case for OpenAI's operator, which is it is a free keylogger Do take security seriously. So, you know, continue with email. You put in some personal secret private email and log in with a code instead. So this code login thing might actually be interesting. If you want people using, logging into your site with agent stuff going on where they don't want to put passwords in through any kind of agentic tool or browser, then having this kind of code-based authentication could be really strong. Ha! Got it. All right, now you're into my Canva. Goodness, what will you see there? Well, you know what? I'm getting loopy. It is late at night. It's time to wrap up this video. I don't know what it's gonna do at the end. Something's happening. But I'm gonna hop up and brush my teeth, and it is way past my bedtime. But yeah, wow. So, okay. I'm Cassie Kozyrkov. I've been in AI and tech for a long, long time, and now I'm on a mission to help senior leaders and their organizations step into the AI era. So if you like what you saw here, you know the standard drill. Like, share, subscribe, all those good things. And if you especially liked what you saw here, I bet that your organization is likely getting various personages to train them in various things. And many of these personages either discovered AI within the last year or so, or maybe the last 4 years, then consider saying to whoever is getting those people to torture the eyes, ears, and hearts of whoever's in your organization to go to makecassietalk.com. Yes, we have ways of making her talk, and inviting me to come help out with some of those things instead. Thank you for joining me, and now I go asleep. I am just far too loopy. Mwah.